CopyCoder basically takes the screenshot that you submit and uses best practices to build prompt that you will then copy from CopyCoder and paste it into Vault.new, into V0, into Cursor, and most other AI tools that are serving out there, no coders like me and many of you. With that being said, I will give you a complete walkthrough about how CopyCoder works, and I will show you samples on how we can achieve exactly what we need in order to succeed only using the prompts that are given by CopyCoder. Stick with me. All I ask you is that if you like this video, please consider liking it. It helped me reach more people. It helped me spread the word about the great news that AI is bringing to us and all these changes from the no-code perspective, from a person that don't know how to code, although I'm learning, so I can understand exactly how these systems work. Also, if you like my content, please consider subscribing. There is no better way to keep up with the content than subscribing, so please consider doing that. But other than that, whether you like or don't like my content, doesn't matter, because all I want is to teach you what I'm learning during my journey as from a no-code developer to an AI coder prompter, to build SaaS software and to build many other things that hopefully would make the world a better place. Right, the first thing that you would want to do is you want to go to CopyCoder. If you have an account, I will leave you the link down below so you can sign up for an account. You get 5 prompts completely free. I already used 2 out of 5, so we're going to use 2 more here for this scenario, and we're going to try them both in Vault and V0. I want to upload my file, and I've been debating between on the Framer website, which I took a running screenshot, or using Bobo. I will give the Figma a try. And this is a web application. We're going to generate the prompt. Right now it's analyzing on the page and is trying to determine exactly how the prompt needs to be done in order for it to work. This is going to take a few more seconds. Let's see. And it's done. So right now we have the initial prompt. I'm going to copy and I'm going to add to the Vault. And I am going to scroll. And we're going to create a new chat in V0. Paste it. We're going to scroll down. And that's because on my last try, I realized that the best way to do it is by creating a page structure. So let me get the page structure. So we're going to add and we're going to send it, and we're going to let it do its magic on its own. So right now, let's look at the prompt. So it's telling exactly how it needs to go about it, including everything from lab navigation elements to the layout to the content sections, to the interactive controls, colors, basically everything is there for you to see. It's going to create a whole bunch of pages. And this is in V0. Let's move these. So beer, Campbell. Let's look at what it's doing in Vault. It's the exact same prompt. It just looks a little bit different, but it's creating all the components and everything. And I don't expect it to look exactly the same, because of course there are animations and there are images that are there. What I do expect is that it will have a similar layout in which we can fill the blanks. And then we can build animations or anything else, in all honesty. So this is the screenshot that we uploaded. Running screenshot that I did markup hero. Great Chrome station, I love it. Let's see how it's going so far. No preview yet. they're both going to take a while because this is a big page and I am asking it to a weekly framer. So as you can see, he's creating dog sample features, pricing resources. He's creating everything that encompass framer. Perhaps I should have broken it down into chunks, but I just copied the prompt from CopyCoder and pasted it into on both of these. So right now it looks like it's time. So we're going to ask to continue generating. Go into vaults. And this has continue. And fire. Please continue. And there is no preview yet. Let's see which one does a better job. I'm assuming that they would both have a date. Okay, here we have an initial psych, which honestly doesn't look that bad, even for the pictures. So that's good. But it's still working. All right, so if I have a problem. All right, so it means that it's pretty much done. Let's leave a framer, vault, framer, vault. It doesn't really look similar. And V0 is still working, so a bit faster. Okay, so he's probably skipped this far. He created a little bit different. It's not exactly the same. And being realistic, this being a brand new tool is probably unrealistic that we... All right, so it didn't generate the page structure. That sucks because it did on 2 of my credits for that. That's what it is. So start with a template. All right, let's see what we got here. All right, so imported some pictures. There's no header. Would have been nice for it to use a little bit more padding. So that's something that hope we can fix using the select feature. We can ask for 56 piece of thing. Well, and please element. But let's continue looking. Okay. Oh, not bad. So overall, decent. Definitely not framer level, but they both did a decent job. I like the vault layout a little bit better because he included exactly what I needed. Not exactly what I needed, but more, a better layout. Let's put it that way, a better design. You got better padding, saying everything else. All right. Take me on the way down. I don't know what happened here. Slow this again. All right. As I said, they both have a very decent, that is a decent new tab. Oh, and the picture changes every time. That's pretty cool. I like it. Never bad. Perhaps this cool change a little bit more to make sure that it looks much better. But overall, I would say it's really decent. The prompt that I got from CopyCoder, I will show you a different prompt that I use for different project, for a different try. So gave me both prompts. The first one was the initial prompt. Let's review it. So it's telling a use stock photos from Pixabay stock photos. Okay. Avoid duplicate. Source and display logos from CVN and design placeholder. Okay. So it's doing everything that it needs to do to ensure that you get a polished output at the end. So this specifically was for a dashboard. I will show you for this dashboard. And it ended up looking okay. Let's see if I didn't delete it so I can show it to you and you can judge it. I think it was this one. Yeah, it's just still working on it. He got some issues that I need to go and fix. Actually, it wasn't even that one. Yeah, I deleted it. Yeah, because this was 26 minutes ago. I stopped working on that like an hour and a half ago. That was second try. Going back to Notion. But it explains everything, the navigation elements on the sidebar. As you can see, it took all the navigation elements that we have in here. And let's shrink this a little bit. So if you compare the navigation elements to the ones that we have on this sidebar, you got dashboard, products, customers, orders, promotions, sales. That's there. And then the secondary navigation under files, which is this one down here, have affiliates, marketing, advertising, and then the channels. Exactly, and this is just a screenshot. Then the layout components, the left sidebar. It's telling you everything that it has. The components section is metrics car. So you get everything. You have interactive controls and with a search bar, create request button, includes the colors. So took the colors from here and added them here to make sure that it stays within brand for the screenshot. There's the project structure, the key features that it needs to have, the routes, the component structure. So everything is there for you to see realistically. It includes, this prompt includes most things that you would have in a really detailed prompt that you will use in this software. It's just that most people don't know what they don't know, and the prompts that they input are not the best, and then the output is not the best. Otherwise, I play with it a little bit, and here we go. And I really like what I get on the page structure. Now let me show you the prompt for the page structure. And this is what it got. So details everything how it needs to be structured to ensure that it's putting out exactly what it needs. So it's good promotions. So what every screen needs to have. I don't know. I would say definitely worth your money. Let's see how much it costs. Costs $15 per month for 25 AI. Image prompts per month. Recently it's going to start generating backend code. It's on the expensive side, given that it's only 25 image generations, but I would say that it's worth your money if you're working on a project and you want to make sure that you're getting exactly what you need. I believe that this is one of those software that you that is going to make your life easier, and it's going to speed up the process. It's going to help you save some credits when using Cursor or Bolt or even V0 is going to save you time. So if you value your time at more than $15 per hour, definitely worth a try. It's not that expensive, but it's only 25 generations. You be the judge. With this, we have reached the end of this video. I really appreciate you taking your time and watching this video with me. If you like my videos, again, please consider liking and subscribing. It really helps me spread the word out about some of the great tools that are out there, help people get started with this, and more importantly, spread out the word that, hey, anybody can build anything, whether that is using no-code tools like Bobo or Framer or Flutterflow, or using AI tools like Bolt, V0, or Cursor. There are many opportunities out there for you to build whatever it is that you want to build. And it only takes a little bit of work and imagination and learning the ins and outs of these tools. But like I said, my personal goal is to help people find those tools. And the best way I can do it is by recording videos, spreading the word out. And the way you can help me help them is by liking this video so the algorithm pick it up and push it out there and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a great rest of your day, and I hope this video helped you learn something new.